Election Commission calls on the public to be on the lookout for candidates campaigning during Maundy, Thursday, and Good Friday. COMELEC Commissioner Louis Guia says candidates are prohibited from wooing voters during these days out of respect for the observance of Holy Week.
Bawal yung Maundy, Thursday, and Good Friday. Well, nasa batas natin na, dapat sa electoral linggo, quiet period ang tawag doon sa mga araw na yon, at quiet period din yung tawag doon sa one day before election. No, now, bawal na yung mga kampanya. Yung one day before election para mag-nilay-nilay ang ating botante at i-finalize siguro nila yung kanilang pipiliin.
On hot copy this morning, the campaign and the campaign season is heating up in Makati. Incumbent Makati Mayor Abby Binay is seeking re-election. Surveys have her ahead of her brother Junjun Binay, and she has the endorsement of no less than her father, former Vice President Jejomar Binay. But will the sibling rivalry divide voters in the city? We have with us this morning Makati City Mayor Abby Binay joins us. Mayor Abby, thank you so much for coming to Head Start once again.
Again.
Yeah. No, I was going to say first, we interviewed you and Junjun when you
before
were both
filing.
Asking each other, yeah, please give me a chance, let me run. That was before the filing.
Yeah.
Now this is after the proclamation. And I have to start first with really the sibling rivalry at this point. I want to ask first, how is the family at this point?
We are campaigning against each other.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
My dad is with me,
yeah,
and everybody else is on the other side.
Yeah.
So,
and how difficult is that? I read an interview where first you had said that even after the elections, you said that the wounds are so deep, the family feud is so deep, that even it may remain after the elections. You said, matatapos ang election, may mananalo, matatalo, pero di pa rin magkakaayos ang pamilya namin. You know, that struck me because it seemed so definitive on your point, on your side.
I think it's because there's so many things that have been said and are still being said that we have to finish the elections first before we even talk about reconciliation. We have to, parang tapusin muna natin, let's finish the elections and then respect the results of the elections. And then you start the healing process because you can't ask for healing now because the war is ongoing. You cannot have reconciliation if lahat nag-aaway pa, di ba? So, it is only after the elections that we can rebuild a relationship, and in all in God's time,
uh-oh,
that we will be able to do that.
Okay, but what kind of leader will you be? I mean, now that Junjun is a formidable opponent to you, I'm curious if and when you win, if you do win again, would you be the type to reach out to him? Because he does have counselors,
mm-hmm,
some leaders that do support him and believe in him. Or would it be, you know what, you went against me, naipit pa yung budget, we'll talk about that,
yeah,
later, you're all gonna pay for it after the elections?
I think it will be, as far as the counselors, his counselors are concerned, it will be very, very difficult for me, considering what they did. Yung magkasama kami, magkakampi kami, and then they just left without any explanation, without even saying, pasensya na, Mayor, dito na kami sa kabila, di ba? Parang ang hirap naman na magtiwala pa sa ganun klase,
uh-oh,
na tao. Because I...
So all 12 of them acted that way?
Yeah. So I treated them well. I mean, I'm very, very professional. Kahit pag tinanong mo sila, sasabihin na bakit naging pabayaba si Mayora sa paglilingkod niya. So hindi naman, hindi lang naman kami close. So that they had personal reasons and not professional reasons why they went for my brother. So it's going to be very, very difficult if we do work together, is to regain that trust that was lost, because the level of betrayal was Grabe talaga. Kaya sabi ko, sa tagal namin sa politika, you kind of get used to it. Yung yeah. kakampi mo ngayon, kalaban bukas, kakampi mo. Pero yung ginawa nila na kaibigan ko sila, tinrato ko silang parang kaibigan, more than an ally, and that's what they did. And I keep asking myself, may ginawa ba akong mali?
Oo.
Nagkulang ba ako? Na para gawin nila yon. So again, if they do win, it will be we will have to start from zero. How will they regain my trust? How will I not think at the back of my head that they're going to do it again?
But you would want a council. I mean, you have some city councils that are criticized for being rubber stamped.
Yes.
But I can imagine if you're the mayor, you don't want a divided council as well. I mean, just recently, the Department of Budget and Management already reenacted the Makati City budget. And would you say Junjun is to blame? Is he behind that?
The thing is, the councillors don't have to be a rubber stamp councillors. They're actually not rubber stamp councillors because they can ask questions. They can. I've included them in the budget process. I make sure that they are part of being able to ask questions to the department. So hindi nila pwede sabihin na hindi sila binigyan ng pagkakataon na pirma lang sila ng pirma, because that's not what happens in my administration. You have the liberty to do your job and ask questions. You have the liberty to pass your ordinances. Very free sila kung ano yung gusto nila, anong advocacy nila, gawin nila. So hindi yan yung tipong I spoon feed them, oh, pirmahan mo. Hindi ganon. Yeah. You can always ask questions.
Uh-oh.
So the thing with the budget,
yeah,
it's because it's an election year, pinulitika nila yung budget. There were certain items that they slashed and they ginalaw-galaw nila, which is, I feel, very, very unfair because it takes 1 year to prepare your budget.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
it took them, what, 2 weeks? Na ganun-ganun yung amounts na parang ikaw,
do you feel,
pinag-aralan namin yun.
Do you feel Junjun had a role in this? Or it's just the loyalty?
I don't know.
Okay.
I actually don't know if it was upon his instructions, but it is very, very unfortunate that they did a poor job about the budget, because again, pinag-aralan namin yan. Our budget process starts in February before we even submit that to them.
Oo. So tanong ko nito, Abby, so the DBM already reenacted the Makati budget, so this might be used against you in the campaign. I wanted to ask you, because the fourth tranche of the salary increases for 10,000 city government employees in Makati nabitin, and Junjun can say that in the campaign and say, see, this is what leadership is all about. If you don't have the support of everyone in the council, you don't have the salary increases promised to you. Paano yun?
Well, the reenacted budget was only until we passed a budget. So our budget, napwersa ngayon yung mga konsihal to pass a budget before the end of March.
Okay.
So as of April 17.
Okay,
today,
so this is new.
April 17, we now have a budget. So may budget na ngayon yung Makati. But because of
not the reenacted budget of the DBM?
No.
You're saying it's the 2019 budget?
They were able to pass the 2019 budget end of March.
So that's a coup on your end.
Again,
you were able to do it during the campaign season.
Napasa nila, but unfortunately, because there's an election ban, the salary increase cannot be given to the employees until after the election,
uh-oh,
which is very unfortunate because you need the money for your tuition of your kids. You need the money, di ba? Siyempre, pinoprograma na nila yan, dadating yung pera ko ng ganito. So, but because very unfortunate yung timing nila, so mabibigay lang yung salary increase ng mga empleyado after the election.
Do you think this was strategic to weaken you?
Oh yeah. There were still budget slashes that they did in the second budget, like yung SPES GIP. That's a summer internship program. We're supposed to provide 8,300 jobs. They slashed it to 1,000. Yeah. So
So you felt it was really a campaign strategy.
Oh yeah. They want to cripple me because they're saying I'm going to use that for politics para bag. But the thing is, it's not for me. Para sa mga tao 'yan eh. If at the end of the day, hindi nila gusto yung mga programa ko, they're not going to vote for me. So they want to make sure that the programs that are nice, the programs that will directly benefit people, will not be felt because it's an election year.
Okay. All right. Also, what's used during the campaign is, today your big story is that they passed actually the 2019 budget. But the DBM at one point also said some of the Makati programs, I think your projection was higher than the approved annual investment program.
True.
So let me just continue this. So in effect, they pointed out that you put in too much.
Yeah, wait, hindi ako ha.
Yeah, the council.
It is not me,
so
it's the councilors.
Okay.
Kasi nga, hindi nila pinag-aralan na mabuti yung budget nila. So what they did, for example, I'm not accurate with the figures, but example, insurance. What they did was they made it 50 million when the AIP is only 20.
Yeah.
So very blatant yung violations Mm-mm. in the budget that the councilors did in the budget that we passed with
so
them.
So do you think that's intentional to also hurt you? Or honestly, put a cloud of doubt over your leadership?
I think it was haphazardly done, the budget. Nila, kasi nagmamadali sila. Hindi nila pinag-aralan ng mabuti. If I'm not mistaken, they're only able to do the revisions to the budget in 2 days' time.
Uh-oh. Because you did tell me that one of your advocacies is to lift, to uplift the Binay name once again, to, of course, after what your father, your brother's been through, to erase, issues on corruption. So I can imagine by allegations like that on the budget.
Actually, it's funny because you cannot say there's corruption on the level of the budget.
Okay.
Because corruption only comes in when you procure. So there's also a possibility that even if it's in the budget, I do not implement the budget.
Okay.
So may mga items doon, may mga projects that I don't want to fund this. I'm not going to implement this one.
Mm-mm.
So hindi pa rin sabihin na pag nasa budget, may corruption na.
Uh-oh.
On the budget level, because the corruption or the overprice only comes in when you implement, when you procure, when you pay.
And that's what you want changed. Is that correct?
Yes.
Uh-oh.
So, hindi po pwede. Kunyari, pag naglagay ka sa budget na t-shirt, 100 pesos. Pero hindi ibig sabihin na 100 pesos makukunin. Pwede 100 pesos, pwede mas mababa.
Okay.
Pero hindi ka pwedeng mas mataas.
Oo.
So the budget is just giving you the flexibility to enforce the project.
Okay.
But there's no such thing as an overpriced budget.
Yun.
Budget nga eh.
Oo.
So parang pag bumunta ka sa palengke.
So when the DBM cites these.
Those are technical. Those are technical infirmities in the budget that the council passed that they have to correct. Because if you implement an inoperative budget, COA will now comes in and files a case against us for implementing an erroneous budget. So kailangan itama mo yung mga mali or else magkakaroon ka ng kaso.
Okay. So clearly, you have businessmen also supporting you, no less than your father. Has sung praises about you and your leadership. Absolutely. I read it. I mean, during your proclamation rally, he did say that you are the most capable, efficient, organized. Now, the campaign of Junjun, his slate is Team Be Nice. Did I read this correctly?
Yeah.
Yes, a Team Be Nice slate. It would seem that if it's Team Be Nice, you are not nice.
So they say.
Oh, yeah. All right. Let's start from that. What is it? Okay. Ito, during the proclamation of rally of Junjun, your sister Anne made a joke and said, maganda ako doon, meaning you, mas mabait ako doon, and I'm not a brat. So you have Team Be Nice, the slate of Junjun, Anne saying she's not a brat, which sort of implies you are a brat. So what is it? I mean, why are they Team Binay? What are you Team what?
And how can they be Team Binay if they're spewing out words like that, di ba? Mm-hmm.
You don't do that? I'm curious.
No. I always say that I can, but I respect my dad that he said that we stick to the issues. And I don't need to go down to personalities.
Again, so you've never gone yet below the belt?
It is always about performance. Okay. No. What I do is I debunk.
Okay.
I can say so many things about him as well, but I won't. Marami rin naman akong pwede ko rin naman siyang patulan, pero I won't because may pinag-aralan ako, susunod ako sa advice ng tatay ko, and at the end of the day, people don't like a negative campaign.
Mm.
People don't like siblings fighting on stage.
Oh, so you believe because, that, talaga?
Because what they want is a positive campaign. The tendency will be, ay, nag-aaway sila, huwag na lang tayo bumoto. But that can't be because it's not about personalities. Parang ano yan eh, brand X, brand Y. It is not the last name. It is not because they have a relationship. But what is the performance that you have done? That's what people should ask. That's what the voters should ask. Hindi mo titignan, Abby Binay ba siya? Junjun Binay ba siya? Or kung sino siya
patate? But the reality in local politics is...
Of course. But I think we have to go beyond that. This is Makati. We have to be more intelligent. Hopefully naman, ang botante sa Makati are more intelligent and more scrutinizing that they look beyond personality.
Okay, so Junjun wants to bring the Binay brand back. Okay, what is the Binay brand under you, under Abby?
And that's always a question if there is such a Binay brand. I think the only person who can claim a Binay brand is my dad. There's no Abby Binay brand, there's no Junjun Binay brand. The original Binay brand is my dad. It's the social services programs. It is malapit sa masa. Yun yung Binay brand. Yung Binay brand, yung masipag magtrabaho. Maybe the Abby Binay brand will be transparency, good governance, stricta pero may puso. That will be the my version of the Binay brand.
Okay, so stricta ka talaga?
I am.
Oo. So ito na, I'll ask. So during this campaign season, si Abby Binay ba, kasi your father was known for KBL, Kasal Binyag Libing.
Yeah.
Oo. Ikaw ba, Abby Binay, are you changing that? I mean, it's different now with younger mayoralty candidates, even Joy Belmonte. So ang tanong ko, just for the record, pumupunta ka ba sa mga libing? What's the style?
Pumupunta naman. Pero syempre, you have to use a millennial touch. You use technology. We are available on Facebook. We are available. We have a Makati Zen app. We have free Wi-Fi, so you can easily contact us. So yung mga reklamo, you can send and text your complaints. Tapos na tutugunan ka agad.
What about the Kasal and Binyag? Your father was known
Kasal
for
Binyag.
Every Kasal Binyag Libing in Makati. And I think Junjun really is doing that same style.
True.
Yeah.
But the thing is, you have to evolve also because the needs of the people also evolve.
How have you evolved?
I focused more on kids.
Okay.
I focused more on the schools. I focused more on disaster and our health services. Those are things that, and of course, my mass transport system. You have to address those things.
Yeah.
How to provide more jobs. Kasi yun naman ang laging tinatanong. Hindi naman yung gusto ba kitang gawing ninang.
Okay.
Diba?
Pero hindi ba ganun noon?
Yun kasi dati, yung klase ng politika, ay, boboto ko yan kasi ninong ko yan eh. Pero kasi ngayon ang tao, ay, boboto ko yan kasi maganda yung binigay niya para sa mga anak ko. Ay, boboto ko yan kasi naibsan yung kahirapan. Yun yung hinahanap ng tao.
Your father was famous in Makati at 5 in the morning, naglalakad na siya sa riles.
Yes.
Tapos nagpapandesal siya. He would be having breakfast. Diba?
True.
He became famous for that. And Junjun must be doing that today. That's how we campaign. It's really like your father.
But my dad is a different politician. My dad is lumaki sa hirap. My brother is not. Hindi naman niya pwede sabihin na sanay siyang kumakain sa karinderya. Kasi my dad's used to that. The same way that I cannot pretend na kumain sa karinderya because hindi ko naman talaga ginagawa yon. You have to also have a level of sincerity. We cannot copy our dad because our dad is different. My dad grew up different. So hindi po pwedeng kukopyahin mo lang kung ano siya. Kasi hindi naman siya magiging mayor if circumstances were different. He was also a lawyer, he was a human rights lawyer, yeah. He was an orphan, he was, kumbaga sa circumstances, ibang-iba, kaya iba din yung personality ng daddy ko. So we cannot be like my dad because we grew up different.
No. Ang tanong ko, have you ever asked your dad, Junjun being the only son, and then he comes out supporting you outright. Well, you have Nancy and that were there on stage with Junjun, and Nancy did admit that meron na talagang parang strain in your relationship ever since before, and then Junjun said that your campaign and your running is fueled by vengeance, okay?
Oo nga eh. Hindi ko alam what he meant by vengeance.
By vengeance, yeah.
It's a presumption na may ginawa sila sa akin, kaya ako nag-gumagante sa kanila. So I don't know what he means by that. I mean, I'm not doing this for vengeance. I can easily walk away, but I'm not because I have so many plans that I still want to do for Makati. And at the end of the day, kung ayaw ng tao sa akin, I will respect that. But I'm not doing this to spite them.
Let's discuss that.
Again, it is not about them. This is not about him. This is not about my siblings. It's not about my family. We're talking about, this is about Makati. So, hindi ito laban ng pamilya. Labanan to ng sino bang mas magaling maglingkod sa Makati. This is not about sino mas mabait, sino mas maganda, sino ang mas magaling na magsisilbi sa Makati. Yun yung dapat na tinatanong. I'll just say that it's very difficult for my dad to choose. Having to choose between your kids is very difficult. But he was not choosing as a father of our family. I think he was choosing as the father of Makati. Who is a better choice to run the city? So hindi siya yung, it was beyond, kasi kung pwede naman niya sabihin, sige, wala na lang akong pipiliin. Bahala na kayong dalawa, mag-away na lang kayo dyan. He could have done that. But he's not. Because sinasabi niya, sino ba bilang ama ng Makati, bilang original na may hawak ng Binay brand, sino ba yung sa tingin ko na magpapatuloy nung legacy namin dito sa Makati?
Oo. Pero it seems that, I mean, there were reports that the Christmas cards of the Binays last December, but this was before the proclamation rally, that's the thing. They were all complete. They were with your father except you.
Actually, you have to take into context. That picture was taken 2 years ago.
Really?
Yes.
Okay, good you explained that.
They only brought that out in 2018. But actually,
why weren't you there 2 years ago?
That picture, because 2017 pa lang, nagpaparamdam na siya.
Junjun.
Yes.
Okay.
So, I said, I don't want to ruin my holidays. I mean, there were a lot of holidays that have been very melodramatic. That I want a happy and peaceful Christmas. So, I decided not to join the pictorial for 2017. Kaya nga funny, when they brought out that picture, it's like, oh, luma na yan eh. That's an old picture that was taken 2017.
Because it would seem when you see that and you're from Makati, na talagang Abby Binay is so uncooperative with her family. Parang ganon. Because it must have been hard for everyone, but they came. Parang ganon ang dating.
I guess if you are...
It's like you're the lone wolf.
Because I am.
You really are.
Yeah. So, this is a long...
Go ahead. Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
It just has been highlighted because of the bickering in politics. Pero yung family issue namin.
Yeah.
Matagal na yun.
Oo. What is it then? I mean, considering you have two sisters.
I have three.
Okay, yeah, forgive
me. I have three sisters. Uh-oh. So, kaya nga sinasabi ko,
it's beyond. What makes you different? Yeah. When I said lone wolf, you said, because I am.
I grew up different. Kasi diba nag-UP Los Baños ako. So, I decide differently. Kaya nga sinasabi ko nga, minsan, I ask, was I switched at birth? Ano ba? Parang, they like being together all the time, which I'm not a groupie. Okay. So, which they don't seem to accept. Yeah. Na, bakit ikaw ganyan? Bakit hindi ka kagaya namin? Yeah. So, it's difficult to explain to them that I'm not like you. Yes, we're siblings, but we have different personalities. Yeah. So, even my mom, it's difficult for my mom to say na, bakit ayaw mo? Bakit yung mga kapatid mo gusto to? Bakit ikaw hindi? So, I'm just really, really different. So, I guess that's also the reason for the family differences. That could be the reason.
Yeah. Who are you closest to in the family?
Now? Before?
Yeah, before. Let's start with before.
Anong timeline?
Before, who were you closest to?
My gosh, that's such a hard question. I think ever since I ended up in studying in UP Los Baños, kasi I'll only come home weekends. So how can you have a relationship with a family sibling? I guess all, because we all grew up together in one house naman. But the thing is, once you start going to college, you barely see each other.
So who are you closest
you have
to
your
today?
Own. Wala.
In the family? What?
My
your dad.
My dad.
But what about your mom?
What about my mom?
Yeah, I just saw her recently in one of the fairs. She's still quite strong, of
she
course.
Is, she
but
is.
How? What's your relationship like with
my,
her?
I'm not really close to my mom. I've accepted for what she is.
Which is?
Alam niyo na yun.
Okay. Uh-oh. Do you feel that your mom favors your other siblings?
My mom tries to be fair.
Okay.
Try being an operative word.
Okay.
Kaya nga sabi ko, we will rebuild after the election na lang. Mm-mm. I mean, you know what? Totoo, physically, this is not, the election's not very tiring.
Okay, physically,
It's the emotional roller coaster.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
I just really want to finish this election so I can move on.
Yeah. But then the surveys are out and you're up more than 60% in Makati. So you have the upper hand.
I do. But still, I just want to finish the elections. Yeah. It's very, very mentally taxing. Day in, day out, you get reports of what they say about you, the lies that they spread about you.
But do you really want to hear it? Or you have to?
You have no choice. Because syempre, ayaw mo naman din na paniwalaan ng tao. If the thing is, when you ignore,
it'll be bigger.
Hindi pinapatulan. Sige, let's keep on repeating it so people will believe that it's true.
Yeah.
So, again, it's a losing proposition because pag sumagot ka, hindi ka sumagot, talo ka pa rin.
Yeah.
So, how do you address it? You have a positive campaign, but at the end of the day, you still have to reply.
Yeah. I'm curious. When Junjun was here, he did say that he believed your father would support him because of his dislike for your husband, okay? Who is running? Luis Campos is running for second district, no?
Yes.
Second district reelection. Former Vice President Jejomar Binay is running first district. First of all, have you forgiven, two questions on your husband. Have you forgiven Junjun for what he said about your husband?
Marami pa rin siyang sinasabi eh. So mahirap magpatawad kung hindi pa rin siya natatapos. They've accused my husband of so many things.
Yeah, yeah. Wanting to take over Makati is the overall...
I know.
Yun yung accusation.
But the thing is, he could have stopped it. Again, when he was talking to my dad, he said, sige, pag hindi na tumakbo si Luis, hindi na ako tatakbo. And my dad approached my husband, and my husband said yes.
Really?
Sige, para hindi na mag-away at maglaban yung dalawang magkapatid, I will back out. When he now, when my dad now goes to my brother, my brother says, ay hindi, tuloy na ako.
Are you serious?
Yes.
So, when was
and
this?
And he cannot deny that. Yeah. This was before the filing.
Right before, after the interview
on
Headstart?
A few months before.
Okay.
A few months before. Kaya nga sinasabi ko, if you really want to badger my husband,
uh-oh,
you had the opportunity for him not to run. So,
okay,
why didn't you take it? You had demands. We said yes. Hindi rin pala yun yung, that still wasn't enough. This is not about my, again, this is not about them, this is not about my husband, this is about what Makati, what Makati will benefit from a better mayor.
I'm curious, under what party is Luis running under? Because is it true that Una refused to endorse him? Is that true?
Una refused to issue a certificate of candidacy.
Okay, all right. Why is that? What's the real score? Does your father dislike him?
It is not my father who was going to issue the COC. It was supposed to be my sister. But because she refused to issue a COC, he had to decide to go to NPC. So, para lang
ba... Pero you're under Una.
Correct.
Okay.
Para rin matapos yung sinasabi nila na substitution. Lagi nilang sinasabi, hindi, ang tatakbo talaga si Luis. Magpapalit yan midstream, magsasubstitute sila. Hindi kami pwede magsubstitute dahil magkaiba kaming party. So they should stop saying that lie, that there is a substitution plan. Because there is no substitute. Sabi ko, ha? Magsasubstitute?
Because what you're trying to say, they're trying to instill some fear and panic with Binay loyalists that if he wins, runs for mayor,
that's why
he
they keep
becomes
on saying
mayor.
It's Binay versus Campos. Because they're saying it's my husband who wants to run for mayor.
So that's the Junjun campaign.
Correct. So ginawa nilang villain, ginawa nilang boogeyman yung asawa ko. Yung asawa ko, tumatakbong congressman lang. Hindi, wala siyang ambisyon na tumakbong mayor dahil kung pwede nga lang na hindi siya tumakbo, parang hindi kami maglaban, umoo siya doon. So bakit na, he's, again, they're portraying him as very ambitious when he's not. They're portraying him as a drug addict. We have imagine, because sinasabi nilang drug addict siya, I had to ask him na pwede ba magpa-drug test ka. So he took a drug test in a government hospital, and it's all negative. So stop spreading the lies.
Yeah.
It's not helping. And how can you say, let's reconcile after? Kung ang dami mong sinabi, ang dami mong kasinungalingan na sinabi, tapos sasabihin mo, alika, reconcile tayo.
Uh-oh. Well, you are clearly very protective of your husband. I mean, I can sense it. You have a good relationship
with him. Kasi kawawa.
Okay.
Every day, they don't attack me, they attack him. They say so many, drug addict, wife beater, drug cuddler. Ang dami na lang galit, hindi okay daddy ko sa kanya.
Yeah.
Mamamatay tao. So very very unfair for them to picture my husband that way. So
how is the relationship between your father, former Vice President Binay, and your husband?
They're okay.
They're okay.
Yeah. They're working together. So paano mo sasabihin na magkaaway sila? My husband has not had any issue with my dad. Hindi kami groupie, di ba?
Yeah.
Hindi naman kami lagi nandun sa bahay ng parents ko. So, but that doesn't mean that hindi siya type ng dad ko.
Mm-mm.
So,
okay. We have 3 minutes to go, so I just don't want you to go. I'm sorry that you cried
I know,
this morning.
Ikaw talaga.
I apologize for that, but your platform, this is important. At 18 billion pesos a year, what you are promising, and I'm gonna run through this, 10,000 new jobs to include seniors. I mean, I'll be honest, it sounds too much. How would you fulfill 10,000 new jobs?
That will be from the subway. That will not be connected to the 18 billion budget. So the 10,000 jobs will be generated from the construction of the subway. And as far as the senior citizens is concerned, that is after the construction, because what we want to do is something similar to Japan, where they hire the elderly, because that's something that we cannot do when in government service because of the civil service laws. So we have asked the company to hire the senior citizens, so they'll have those able-bodied, diba?
That's a
they
good one.
They can still make money. So at least the subway will generate 10,000 jobs for the construction, which will prioritize the Makati residents and the senior citizens at the same
this
time.
Subway is your legacy project, and it's big. And Junjun
it's
Binay,
200 billion big.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Junjun Binay was here at one point before, and he said, did you really study it? He even claimed that a subway wasn't necessary.
Really?
No, for that area, he said.
The thing is, when you are a university, when you study in UMAC, kulang kami sa sasakyan when you have to go home. It is false to say that it is unnecessary because you look at the traffic. What you want to do is to discourage people to use their cars.
I was going
to
say
you're going to tell people you want to lessen the carbon emission. You want people to walk more or use their bike more, and you have your mass transport system. You want them to have less cars. So you're going to say, I don't need a car anymore because I can just take the subway. So it is not whether it is necessary, but it is the timing. Aantayin mo pa ba kung kailan kailangan mo siya bago mo siya itayo?
Okay. Binanggit mo rin libreng baon pagkain for public school students. Ang tanong, you're already mayor. Couldn't you have done that?
We are working on a 2019 budget. It's not in the AIP.
Okay.
So
wala ito. I mean, people can ask
you. It is not something in our budget this year.
Okay.
It also depends on our collections. So you cannot say that I'm going to do all this if your collections are low. So it really depends on that, again, on your collection, your budgeting, what is going to be your priority. So you have an 18B, but what is your priority?
Okay.
So it's like a big pie. Are you going to get a big piece of the pie for infra, for disaster, for education? So it's just allotting your funds properly.
Okay. Just very quickly, I'll run through it. So the list given to me, of course, is this seems to be roughly the Binay brand, urgent care in barangay, CCTV in every barangay, an area for ambulant vendors, free checkup for 50 years old and above, only dialysis. I mean, ang tanong, this dialysis even in QC, this seems to be a very big
issue.
Yes. Ang tanong nang yan pag sa campaign is, nakaupo ka ng mayor eh. Ba't di mo pa ginawa nung nakaupo ka?
No, actually, we're doing that now. The only dialysis is happening now. So you have a PhilHealth coverage of number of sessions, and we have yellow cards, so you have X number of sessions that's being covered as well. But now, in excess of the number of sessions that is covered by the PhilHealth and the yellow card, we will cover 4,500 of all your sessions. So in excess of that, ikaw na magbabayad. Yeah. But usually, it costs like 4,853. It depends on you, on the service provider where you have your dialysis. But we assure you that you have a 4,500 kitty per session. Kaya naging only dialysis siya.
Okay.
So we're doing that now.
That's not
a campaign promise. We're already doing it.
Okay. All right, last words. Clearly you're watched in Makati right now.
Well, I'm just hoping that everybody will go out and vote. There's such a thing as if you don't vote, you can't complain, because there's a tendency when you're leading, di na sila boboto. So hopefully you all come out and vote for the right person, because if you don't, you're going to regret it for the next 3 years until the next election. So hopefully I've been able to do my share in the past 3 years. If you like the changes that I've introduced in my administration, then that is enough. I don't really have to say so many things anymore because my performance will stand for itself.
On that note, Mayor Abby Binay, thank you for coming to the show.